Michigan Rundown Podcast.
Walton, Chapman, hoist a three. Michigan wins! At midcourt, extra pass. And it goes for the win!
Presented by Jake Singer. Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of the Michigan Rundown Podcast. Wow, that introduction was the coolest thing I've ever collaborated on. I worked with Maxify Designs to create the introduction, and it sounds amazing. So I'd like to thank Maxify Designs for helping me create that intro. And if you would like any other designs, go to Maxify Designs on Instagram or Twitter. So getting into this podcast today, I really want to focus on my predicted starting lineup for the Michigan football team starting the 2019 season. I think it's really interesting because we have had a lot of players go to the draft this past NFL draft, and there are a few true freshmen that are coming up that could also take some starting positions from some players. So our team will look kind of different this year, and I really want to get into who I believe could be in the starting lineup for this year's football team. On today's episode, we're going to start with the offense. So quarterback, although there have been talks of being a battle for the starting lineup between Dylan McCaffrey and Shea Patterson, in my eyes, I still see Shea Patterson as the guy to go on opening day for the Michigan Wolverines to start behind the center. He started every game last season after transferring from Ole Miss. He completed 64.6% of his passes, and he threw for 2,600 yards and 22 touchdowns, comparing to only 7 interceptions total all of last season. Now we have a new offensive coordinator in Josh Gattis. I think he should shine brighter. I can see the Wolverines definitely redshirting true freshman Cade McNamara and Dylan McCaffrey being the backup quarterback. You know, with the new offensive coordinator in Josh Gattis, he likes to run a more spread offense and allows the quarterback to kind of make more of his own decisions. In this case, you know, we all know Shea Patterson likes to run with the ball, and last season he didn't get as much of an opportunity to really run and show off his legs. And I think he's very quick and is very agile, and if he can really get an open field, he can make defenses really worry about his running ability. So for my pick at quarterback, I choose Shea Patterson. Now, which some of you might not know actually about our Michigan football team, is this year our offensive line is going to be unstoppable. We have so many linemen this year who have proven that they can be at the top of the rankings nationally. And we're going to start with left tackle. John Runyon, in his first full season as a starter last year, he earned all Big Ten first team honors and was named the team's top offensive lineman. He's a big man who will be the protector to Shea Patterson. I don't see him stopping at all. I see him still going. He's one of the veterans on this team now. He's a full year under his belt. And in one year, he made all Big Ten first team. So look to see what he does his second year. I think he could be actually a top draft pick in this year's upcoming draft. But at left tackle, it's one of the most important positions on the football team, and especially on the offensive line. He is the sole protector for a ready quarterback in Shea Patterson. So John Runyon's going to have a big role this year, and I see him being the starting left tackle without a doubt. Very similarly to John Runyon, at left guard, I have Ben Bredesen. Bredesen is the glue and the most experienced lineman of the group. He was the captain last season and was named the team's toughest player. He was second team All Big Ten and has made 32 starts at left guard. And I see him making his 33rd start on opening day. It has that veteran personality. He is a captain of this group. He runs that offensive line, and he has a lot of experience under his belt. Again, very similar to Runyon, I see him actually being a very high draft pick. Look for him to do very well this season. Definitely make all Big Ten first team and get drafted pretty high in the NFL draft next season. Ben Bredesen at left guard. Now, John Runyon and Ben Bredesen are both superb offensive linemen, but my favorite offensive lineman is center Cesar Ruiz. He dazzled offensive line coach Ed Warner in his first full season as starter last fall as a sophomore. Coming in as a junior this year, he will definitely make the start at center again. He was All Big Ten third team and has made 18 career starts, including all 13 last year at center. He could definitely be a top first round pick in next year's NFL draft as well. He's big, he's smart, he just can read a defense very well. He is the captain and is the glue to that offensive line, and I see him being under center once again to start the year. Now, John Runyan and Ben Bredesen are both superb offensive linemen, but my favorite offensive lineman is center Cesar Ruiz. He dazzled offensive line coach Ed Warner in his first full season as starter last fall as a sophomore. Coming in as a junior this year, he will definitely make the start at center again. He was All Big Ten third team and has made 18 career starts, including all 13 last year at center. He could definitely be a top first round pick in next year's NFL draft as well. He's big, he's smart, he just can read a defense very well. He is the captain and is the glue to that offensive line, and I see him being under center once again to start the year. So as I've said, the offensive line is coming in as a very experienced group this year. The offensive line is probably the most intact group of the whole Michigan football team, and they're definitely one of the best offensive line cores in the country. And to add to this very veteran-type group is right guard Michael Owenu. I see him starting at right guard once again. He originated from Cass Tech and was third-team All-Big Ten last season. He made 21 starts and 33 games he has played at Michigan. He's a solid starting role at right guard. I don't see anybody else beating him out for the position. So, as I've said before now, John Runyan, Brent Bredesen, Cesar Ruiz, and Michael Owenu, all starters last season, are definitely going to carry over to being the starting offensive lineman this season. So, unlike the other four offensive linemen, at right tackle, I have Andrew Stubner as the starting right tackle to start the year. He was the new face in the lineup at the end of last season. He was a redshirt freshman who replaced Juwan Bushel-Beatty at the end of last season, who had a toe injury, and he had started the Ohio State game. When Bushel-Beatty opted out not to play in the bowl game, Stuber started again. So Andrew Stuber, although he did not start all of last season, he had some key starts, especially in the Ohio State game and in the bowl game, and I see him now coming in as the starting right tackle to start the year. So this offensive line core is going to be very tough to get around. They're all experienced, they're veterans, and they're role models. They can really teach all these incoming offensive linemen who are trying to come to the University of Michigan this year as freshmen or even underclassmen as sophomores as well, and can really teach them how to become better offensive linemen. I see all these guys becoming the starting offensive line for quarterback Shea Patterson. Now, of all the positions on the Michigan offense, there is no other solidified position than at fullback with Ben Mason. Mason showed some versatility last season and also had a big first half against Nebraska, scoring 3 touchdowns, which, may I add, I was at that game for. He had 80 yards on 33 carries for 7 touchdowns last fall. He is just a lock at the fullback position. I would love to see him be a better blocker this season, since our running back position is kind of up in the air, and he needs to really, you know, fill that void and be a big blocker and a big guy that can fill the gut and make way for our running back. But definitely see him having just as large of a role, even if not a larger role, on the Michigan offense. We see Harbaugh loves to use Ben Mason because he's just a sure-handed guy in short yard positions, especially like on the 1 yard line or with 4th-and-1s, 3rd-and-1s, just short yard positions. Ben Mason always gets the yardage that is necessary. So he is a lock at the fullback position. Now, my personal favorite position to decide about and talk about and debate about is running back this season. You know, Caron Higdon is gone, and Caron was everything that a Michigan running back should be. He was versatile, he got touchdowns, he was a sure-handed guy who can get a lot of yards in a big way. So now that he's gone, there is a huge role to fill with running back. And personally, I still don't know for sure who's going to be the starting running back to start the year. So for right now, I'm going to go with my gut and know what Harbaugh usually does. And Harbaugh usually goes with the veteran guys. And I see Christian Turner as the running back to start the year. Turner played in 3 games last season as a freshman, and he was able to preserve his redshirt year. So with the status of veteran back Chris Evans being out for the entire season, Turner should probably be the starting running back. He had 99 yards on 20 carries last season, including 7 for 32 yards in the bowl game. That being said, do not be surprised to see any action from True Wilson and the true freshman Zach Charbonnet. I could definitely see Charbonnet being the starter by the middle of the season. But to start the year, I see Harbaugh going with Christian Turner, knowing he's been with the program for a year, he's been working with the coaches, and he should probably get the call to start the year off. Now, much like the offensive line, the two sure-handed positions on the Michigan offense is the wide receiver core. Donovan Peoples-Jones and Nico Collins are for sure going to be the numbers one and two wide receiver for this Michigan offense this year and for Shea Patterson's weapons. Donovan Peoples-Jones has been described by his teammates as a freak athlete, and I stand by that 100%. He led the team with 8 touchdowns last season and had 612 yards on 47 catches. He'll be the number one wideout for this new and improved offense. Again, Josh Gattis is coming in here with a lot of ideas as a new offensive coordinator. So I can definitely see Donovan Peoples-Jones opening up the field, going deep, spreading the offense out, and just doing what opponents in the past have done in Michigan. Against Ohio State scored majority of their touchdowns on slant routes. And Donovan Peoples-Jones has the speed to do that as well. I can see him being a downhill threat, but as well as just being those short gains that Shea Patterson can rely on to get big yards in a big way. So Donovan Peoples-Jones is definitely going to be the number one wideout for this Michigan offense this upcoming fall. And last but not least, we have Nico Collins as a number two wide receiver for this Michigan offense. The sure-handed Collins, like Donovan Peoples-Jones, will be a junior this fall. He had 632 yards on 38 catches and scored 6 touchdowns right behind DPJ. Now, look for him to have a breakout year and become a problem for defenses across the country. Not to mention, he is on the 247 sports list for top 10 most underrated players this upcoming year. I definitely see that. People don't realize that Nico Collins is a big, big guy. He is tall, he can get up there, but he's also really fast. Just like Donovan Peoples-Jones, I can see him going for deep routes and catching those hard balls that Shea Patterson can throw him. But at the same time, he can just run those little slants and the small curls to get big yardage in a quick way. Nico Collins and Donovan Peoples-Jones are going to be one of the best wide receiver cores in the country this year. They're both veterans, they're experienced, and they're very good at what they do. So Donovan Peoples-Jones and Nico Collins are my picks to be the number one and two wide receiver core for this Michigan offense. Now, if you look at the whole offense in total, you have a lot of good things happening here. Our offense, for one, is very experienced. All of them have at least started a year on this Michigan team. Now, besides right tackle Andrew Stuber and tight end Sean McCune, everybody else has a lot of experience on this Michigan offense. Not to mention, though, Sean McCune and Andrew Stuber still have had experience playing in big-time games. And, you know, this includes Ohio State bowl games and so forth. So I have no doubt that this Michigan offense is going to produce a lot of points and make a lot of defenses scared. They are highly ranked, they're highly motivated, and they are ready to show up this season. Look for Shea Patterson to have a breakout year this year. He did very well last season, but I can still see him do a lot better. He only threw for 2,600 yards. I can see him throwing for 3,000 yards this season. Look for Donovan Peoples-Jones and Nico Collins to each have at least 7 touchdowns this year. Look for Sean McCune to produce a lot more yardage and have more than just a single touchdown. And not to mention, our offensive line, no one's going to get around them. They are huge guys. They are veterans. They know what they have to do to win football games. And if our offensive line can produce very well, it doesn't matter who's behind at running back, whether it's Christian Turner, True Wilson, or Zach Charbonnet. So in total, I am so excited for this Michigan offense this year. I'm ready to see what they can do, and I have no doubt that they will win games.